So here is a short introduction how to do testing with Netbeans. So Netbeans and object-oriented programming with Java has been taught in the object-oriented programming course, and here I will cover just simple application. Okay, so we are now using NetBeans, and we have this main class here. There is basically nothing, but we are just printing out that our system is working, and then we are using this car class. This is a very simple class. We have a two string variables, manufacturer and model. And then we have setters and getters for those variables. And then there are two constructors, one without any parameters and the second one with both manufacturer and model. And when we are using this default constructor, we are just printing out. Now we are building a ladder, and we are printing and car has been created. And then when we are using these parameters, we are using them also in this print. So as we are now building a Tesla, we will get Tesla. But let's see. Let's run the program. Yes, it did build. Okay, and then we can try and build another car. A default car. Just like this. Let's see what happens. Yes, the car was created, and now we would like to see some testing whether this is actually working as it's supposed to work. We can build new tests here, create an update test, and we want to test public methods here, and let's add test initializer. What happens? We got this car test file. It's not here, but it's here in the test package. Here, this is the file. And now we have there are methods like to test this get manufacturer and set manufacturer and get test get model and test set model. But what we actually want to test is this let's first test unnamed car. So like this. So what we want to do is to create a car. And then we want to oh, so we want to check that it is ladder that we are getting, and we do that by comparing comparing this expected result to this new car get manufacturer like this. Let's see what happens. Oh, now I pressed wrong button. I just run it, but so there are we can run it with F6 and test project with Alt and F6. That was my intention. Okay, so tests run 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, this was not this first, second, third, fourth, fifth. No failures. So if we now want to modify this so that the default car is not Lada, it's just car and model. And now if we run the tests again, now we have seen that 80% of those tests got finished, as these are empty. But then there is a one test that failed, and it says that it expected Lada, but it was car, so it's not working. Of course, we want to fix the test too, and we could also test the let's move this car manufacturer and car model. So let's build a car here and then test this and this should be here in the constructor. Yes, and then we have actually in this bar should be here. Now we can run the test, and all the test passes. Now we can also test some other car. So let's test Tesla and the Tesla. What we want to do is to build Tesla build a Cybertruck. Yeah, and then we have a Tesla here. And now we can run the test. It will fail. Yeah, it failed, as I said. So we were expecting Tesla, but we got Cybertruck. So this test itself is failing. Because here we have a model, not manufacturer. Yeah, so now we have test, so we can build cars. And now test should go through. Yeah, all tests are passing. But what if we want to do something else to the so these cars? Pretty much they cannot do anything. So let's add some feature here. But as was mentioned in the lecture video, let's try test-driven development here. So let's first write the test. So we want to test, let's say, driving. Drive would be actually better. So we want to build a car and then we want to drive the car. And let's set variables here. And then what else we would need? Let's see. Tesla here and model Y here. Yeah, so then we can build it. And what we are expecting when we are driving with Tesla, we are expecting results driving with and if, when we are driving with electric car, it says just bzzz. Now we have, let's put this also some more general and what we are doing, we are driving. So now we can run the tests and if it will of course fail. Yeah, it did fail. So there is no drive method at all. So we need to build this method. That's not that hard. It should not be that hard. Let's build it. It returns string. Does not take any arguments at all, so yeah, it should of course return the string. And now let's try to build this string. What does it say? So yeah, now we are, let's see, we can use switch case here and what we are wanting to use as the variable, it's the manufacturer. Here. And the first case is Tesla. And then we add to this string. Let's first add to the string the, it should be, what should it be? driving with manufacturer. Yeah. So driving with now, if we have a Tesla, then we can of course say bzz and brake here. And if we have a, let's say, Ford, who has Ford? I don't. It just says boom. Break, and then we could have some other case. Let's say, no, Lada is always great. I have a Lada, yeah. Something like that, and break. And we could also have some default thing here. Something like that. Okay, and now if we want to test this, let's see what happens. It did fail. So we were expecting driving with Tesla bzz, but it was driving with Tesla bzz. So there was not enough Z's. Was it like this? No, it was not. Let's put one more. And now all the tests have been going through. But we could also test some other cars. So let's build another car. Yeah, this my code logic is not the best one. Let's leave this here and let's build another car straight away. Car 2. Manufacturer is Ford. And model is Mondeo. And then let's also build a car 3. Let's build a Volkswagen ID.3. And then we can just use this here and here, and once again, when we are building a Mondeo, we would like to hear vroom, and with Volkswagen, we would like to hear vroom, and now something is failing. So, I totally forget that we have this kind of a the default should be no, of course it should be this. Now we can run it. Yeah, I'm doing this so backwards. No one wants to hear it. So here we have. Yeah, you should write the test first and then the code. So we were expecting it with, let's two here and modify this to have two. But it's there is no any other letters. Oh, and now we got the test passing. So now we first were writing this test, and then we wrote code to support the test, and after that I did some modifications, so that was not good. You first modify test and then you modify the code. But here is a simple demonstration how you do unit testing with NetBeans. Oh, we have just a simple program, and we created a simple test also. Now we could actually remove these tests as we are not using them. Now it is not saying that many tests are passing. Now we have four tests and they are all passing, which is good. So this is the way to build unit tests.